I'm a kid, man. I'm a kid at heart.
Ted DiBiase.
I'm not a wrestler anymore. Who am I? I'm here serving. I'm teaching these kids, just loving on them, serving them. At WrestleMania 26, I wrestled Randy Orton and Cody Rhodes in a triple threat. That's when Legacy imploded. And I'll never forget the walk out to that ring. That was a long, long walk.
Tonight, young Ted takes his first step to creating his own legacy. 22 years after his father made his WrestleMania debut.
And then that match.
DiBiase with a clothesline.
I remember thinking to myself, is that it? Is that what I've worked so hard for? At that moment, I realized, okay, what's my next goal? I did everything I set out to do. I turned a dream into a reality. That's where life kind of got a little bit difficult for me.
I absolutely loved what I did. As a father, looking at my son and knowing all that I went through in my career, it wasn't my first choice of vocations in life for him.
My contract had come up. I had been offered another contract and a 5-year deal, and it was very generous, and I'm very grateful for that offer. But for me, it was one of those crossroad moments. I had just had my first son.
Proud papa, right here. See that resemblance?
Am I going to continue down this road and spend 300 days out of the year away from him?
Hi.
Or am I going to make the difficult choice to give up my dream and what I had sought to do all my life?
He called me and he said, you know, he says, I've come to a place of understanding where, you know, the amount of time required of the business, I won't have any time with my family.
I wanted to be the one that teaches him how to fish, play sports, be a coach. I made the right choice. It was a difficult choice, but I felt true conviction for. When I left in August 2013, I really was terrified. How can I provide for my family was like my first initial reaction. I didn't know what to do. October 12th last year was a very dark day for me. It was the best, worst day of my life. My wife was 27 weeks pregnant, and we were about to have a son, and out of nowhere, she got really sick and was feeling very uncomfortable. And long story short, we go in there and they put the thing on her stomach and there's no heartbeat. Whew, man. That was the day that I lost a son. That was the first time I'd ever lost anybody in my life. All the stresses, all the worries about things that are meaningless. I mean, trying to search and find this new identity. I'm not a wrestler anymore. Who am I? That day, October 12th, is where it started. My son saved my life because that's when I began to focus on things that really matter. I learned how to live my life on mission instead of just setting goals my whole life. What am I living for? Am I living just for myself or something that's greater than me? We are currently at Twin Lakes, and this is our HOD Ignite Sports Camp. I've been speaking at this camp for the past 4 years.
The Ignite camp is in its 7th year. Ignite, though, as a ministry, has come under the umbrella of Heart of David.
Heart of David is the name of our ministry because David was the least likely. He was the castaway, he was the runt, but David's also the one that killed a bear with his bare hands, giant with a rock, conquered nations, and ended up becoming a king. So our goal is creating leaders. We're igniting warriors, but we're creating leaders by what we're doing.
I got some warriors up in here.
this is the first year that we have joined forces.
We bring out inner city kids. Got lakes, canoeing, they can swim. There's big trampolines in the water. They've got fields where we do our football and baseball, soccer. Oh, it's incredible.
Oh, I would have caught it, bro.
Yeah.
I would have caught it. Hey, y'all bring it in, man.
We got kids out here that have been physically abused. They're fatherless, and their mothers either work three jobs so they never see them. And it's sad, and but it's the truth.
Is she?
What's up, man? Woo!
Look, hey, hotty toddy right here, bro.
I'm here serving, you know, and I'm teaching these kids and just loving on them, serving them.
You can change the next generation. You can beat racism. You can overcome poverty. Is that gonna change?
Yes, sir.
The deck of cards they got dealt was not as good as mine.
Listen to me, look in my eyes when I say this. I mean it with all my heart. You are an average of what you surround yourself with, okay? What's my favorite quote?
Dream.
Oh, y'all do better. The dream is free, but the journey is not. One more time.
The dream is free, but the journey is not.
And that's John Maxwell quote, okay? So I give him credit. All right? All right, y'all get back to work.
There we go. Now flip it. Oh. There we go. Take it to
What I love about being out here is I'm a kid, man. I'm a kid at heart.
No, I'd be the one, you know, be running. I'd be like... I can do a mad Pele kick, all right? Better than Kofi Kingston. Yeah, I said it. I said it, Kofi. I said it, you know. What is it? Booty-os? Booty-os? What? Watch this.
So we had a wrestling event. Obviously, I'm a wrestler. Got to have some wrestling. All the kids we have, the horrible background some of them come from. We wanted to create some perspective while at the same time doing something really cool for somebody. There's a local kid who is a patient at Batson Children's Hospital, Josh Sexton. And Josh is battling cancer. He's fighting for his life. He's a warrior. Josh just had his arm amputated. His mom told him, said, Josh, I'm sorry, honey. They're going to have to take your arm. You know what his response was? That's okay, Mommy. That just gives me an opportunity to learn how to do new things. That's a positive outlook on life. Throw that kid anything and he's gonna like twist it into positivity. Courtesy of the WWE, we were able to present Josh with the WWE Championship. Good buddy was gracious enough to do a video.
I want you to watch the screen.
Hey Josh, it is me, WWE superstar and 15-time champion, John Cena, with a very important message. I'm actually here at Monday Night Raw, and I just wanted to say thank you. Thank you for being such a huge WWE fan. As you know, the words that I live by are never give up, because sometimes in the WWE, times get tough. But no matter how tough they get, I keep fighting. And the reason I go by Never Give Up is because of people like you. Because no matter how tough times get, you always keep fighting. Thank you for being an inspiration to me. Hopefully see you Raw soon.
This is a warrior. This is someone who has strength. This is someone who has an incredible outlook on life, even though he's facing death. He's still living.
How awesome is this?
You too.
That was the highlight of this weekend for me. The dream is free, but the journey is not. Very few people have the guts to actually get on the path and take the journey, because it's hard. I really was terrified after I left WWE, but now I'm getting to that zeroed in focus like I was when I was wanting to become a wrestler. Now I have something that I can focus on. Planning and helping create this camp and creating the foundation of something that is hopefully going to go on, I'll be able to pass down to my son. And I play a lot with my son, because that was a big reason that I left WWE. I get to come home every night, sleep in my bed, be there with my wife, take her out to dinner, go on dates. It's just life, and I love it. My day-to-day is my family first, and then my work, and then somebody needs some help. Spending time with these kids, man, I want to pour into their lives. I want to create more success stories.
Our hope is that these kids walk away from this camp believing in themselves. We want them to walk away going, I can do this. I can make a stand, I can make a difference, and I can be whatever I want to be.
Guys, I love you. I appreciate y'all being out here. Y'all build each other up. Positive, positive, positive. Help each other, okay?
If you can't tell, I'm pretty passionate about it.
We're saying you don't have to be an MMA fighter. You just have to be concerned about your, you know, your personal safety. Just want to feel like you could handle a bad situation if it came your way. And all of a sudden, they are completely skilled and they're confident, and you see it translating to other areas of their life. That's when you say, I'm really making a difference.